distortion and failure. Don't force a speaker to its limit, you're risking it to get the term of failure or mechanical failure. And worse, your amplifier might have inadequate protection that would make itself vulnerable to issues like channels that are not amplifying sound anymore. Make sure the master speaker swaps with the power amp output power so that you are not risking your system to go dead. If you are trying to go loud outdoor, most especially bass, make sure to check the link in the description below, and make sure to have as many speakers as possible that would satisfy your outdoor needs, most especially in bass. So tap pipe already, okay? So you see this good open field, and you have a bookshelf speakers, and you have 10,000 audience who will be listening at your open field. What happens is that you push volume so that you would satisfy the very last person from the event, and what happens is you suffer from power, inadequate power, and what happens is you burn them, and it's very wrong. Using wrong speaker on the wrong application, you are trying to satisfy the needs of 10,000 people outdoors, and the product family of the speaker where it belongs is only suitable for 50 people and below. If you want to go loud outdoors, spend as much money on professional audio systems that would produce real power RMS that would satisfy the needs more than 10,000 people outdoors. Okay, this is the good example of a good outdoor speakers. As you could see in here, the speakers would reproduce very loud at outdoors, but it's still inadequate because you still need to add more stacks of speakers so that you could hear it properly. Well, there are a lot of factors that would affect it, even though it is really designed for outdoor use. So let's go to top 4. So you can see this, there are two subwoofers that are away from each other, and they are only two pieces. So if you have that kind of setup, you're very wrong, stacking the speaker the wrong way. You're in an open field outdoors, and you stack your false speakers away from each other, most especially that they are not as many as required. So you are risking burning again, which is very wrong. If bass speakers outdoors, make sure it is big, very, very big, really, and many, and has adequate, very clean power. If mid-high speakers outdoors, make it many as possible and reduce low frequency from entering it to make it reproduce sound easily. So this is the proper way of stacking them, so just stack them at the middle and you would get good results. Even though people tell it's for party and club and rave, well, they're wrong. You could also try experimenting, guys, if you're not real, but it depends on you. I'm just suggesting here, okay? And I'm seeing those problems. So top 3, don't make Jerry mad. If you don't use the proper equation to set your delay tower speaker so that the people on the very last seat would be in good shape in hearing those sound from the foe, make sure that you use the correct formula. So what happens here is the velocity of sound is equals to the X over time, so that you can get the proper calculations, just some distance from foe to the delay tower speakers to get the proper sound effect on the very last seat of the people. You need to apply the formula or else you would get people mad like this Jerry on here. So, setting the delay tower incorrectly. You can hear that it is better when the delay towers are working together with the foe, as it increases the listening experience entertainment level. But what we did is that you just put delay and don't